Greetings and welcome to this week's Primed Insight. My name is Steven. I'm a manager here at BlastOne. This week we want to explain the importance of testing your abrasive particle size. Now it's common to test for salt or moisture, as well as the connectivity of an abrasive, but we often overlook the particle size, which is very important to your project success because it's the size of the particles that do all the work. Now, why measure particle size? Well, there are two main reasons contractors want to understand the ratio of particle sizes in their abrasive. The first is to make sure the abrasive you're buying will actually do the work you need it to do. Removing thick coatings and impacting the profile requires larger size particles, while removing corrosion and cleaning out pits require smaller size particles. The needs of your project should dictate the ratio of particle sizes in the abrasives you buy. Another reason for testing particle size is to ensure when you're recycling abrasive that you don't have dust building up in the reclaimed materials, as well as to make certain you're maintaining a good working blend. Recycled abrasive will get finer and finer with subsequent usage, and so facilities oftentimes purchase bags of pure 36 mesh to top off the reclaimed materials just to fortify the proper ratio of large working particles. Testing guarantees there are enough fine particles to clean the surface and enough coarser particles to break the coating or corrosion off the surface. A good particle size distribution looks like this, whereas a very narrow distribution, as shown in this graph, will make for poor performance on various applications. Now, using a BlastOne Abrasive Test Kit makes the testing process simple and convenient, either in your facility or in the field. It comes with a full set of sieves specifically matched to the abrasive in use. Now, this set is for garnet and other expendable abrasives. It also comes with a graduated cylinder and a funnel. To conduct the test, first scoop a representative sample of your abrasive mix, making sure it's well blended and non-separated. Simply fill the graduated cylinder to a precise 50 milliliters, tapping the cylinder to remove any air pockets. The test sieves are stacked in a vertical column with each segment filtering for smaller particles as we go down. So as we pour the abrasive into the column, the larger particles are captured near the top and the finer particles continue downward, stopped at their respective size by the sieve mesh inside. The sizes of each sieve were carefully chosen to test for a proper distribution of particle size. Now, you simply shake the column for a minimum of 2 minutes to ensure the finer particles make their way down and are accounted for properly. We also suggest some gentle tapping on a hard surface to assist with the downward flow. We can now separate the individual sieves so we can measure the accumulated abrasive and determine the ratios of the mix. Using the funnel, empty your top sieve into the cylinder, tap to remove air pockets, and then measure the volume. So for example, this topmost sieve collects particles larger than 20 mesh, which are the very coarse particles needed to cut thick coatings, and its volume comes in at 8 milliliters, which represents 16% of our abrasive's blend. Because we tested with 50 milliliters, we can simply convert whatever volume we get into a percentage by doubling it. So 8 milliliters out of 50 milliliters equals 16% of the overall ratio. Once you recorded your measurement, you can empty the cylinder and continue down the column in the same manner. Things to consider. Now, particles larger than 30 mesh will cause you to use more abrasive, as well as increasing your profile and paint consumption. So unless you're needing to remove extremely thick coatings or desire a profile around 4 mil, which is 100 microns, 30 mesh and larger should be kept at a minimum, probably absent from your blend. Also, pay careful attention to how much of the abrasive is collected within the 50 mesh and the lower 80 mesh sieves. It's the particles between 50 and 80 mesh that clean out the surface pits. It's critical you have a lot of particles within that distribution. When blasting new steel, approximately 75% of your abrasive should fall between the 70 to 120 mesh screens. The particles smaller than 80 mesh are important, but will have a very difficult time cutting through thicker coatings. And so if their relative percentage is high, it will bring down your productivity. A particle smaller than the last 140 mesh sieve will accumulate in the very bottom pan, and this is regarded as unusable dust. And it's very important that this should never exceed more than 3 to 4% when testing recycled abrasive, and no more than trace amounts when testing new abrasive. Finally, this kit allows you to quickly field test and make corrective adjustments to your abrasive mix. so that you can both reduce dust and increase productivity. We recommend that for important projects, every newly delivered batch of abrasive be tested to check that it's within specification. In recycling environments, we recommend daily inspection for large projects and weekly testing in smaller facilities. Now, if you find high volumes smaller than 80 mesh, and particularly in the bottommost dustpan, you may need to adjust your recycler to pull out more fines and dust so as not to dilute the working power of your abrasive mix. Now, this will probably mean an increase in abrasive consumption, but the massive benefit is lower dust and an increase in productivity. If you enjoy these videos, please hit like or leave a comment below. Thanks for watching this week's Primed Insight. We'll see you again next week.